Hey guys, welcome to another exciting video. We hope you all are doing good. As you have already seen the thumbnail, you already know what will be the topic today. Yes, today we will learn about Vishnu Narayan Bhatkhande, from whom we are learning classical Hindustani music through his procedures. Therefore, without any further ado, let's move forward. If you are new to this channel and like the content we post, then go and hit the subscribe button and push the bell icon to be updated first when we upload a new exciting video. Let's get started. Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhatkhande holds an important place in the history of Hindustani classical music. He was born on 10th August 1860 in Mumbai on the day of Janmashtami. He was educated first in Mumbai and then in Pune. He was a lawyer by profession and was recognized as a solicitor in Mumbai. Due to his interest in music, he got a sitar education from Mr. Ballavadas in his life. After this, he received the education of vocal music from Mr. Belbakar, Mian Ali Hussein Khan and Vilayat Hussein. He became detached from his life due to the premature death of his wife and daughter. After that, he devoted his entire life to the practice of music. Music books were not popular in those days. People used to learn music based on the guru-disciple tradition, or we call Guru-Shishya Parampara. But Panditji wanted to make it universal. They wanted to have a music course and students should know about the classical aspect of it. He met many music masters and gurus across the country, but most of the gurus did not agree with them. Many musicians did not even recite their ragas and restrictions to everyone. Sometimes they used to sing only one of their special restrictions so that no one could copy it. There was no system of phonation. In such a situation, in the programs of these masters, Panditji used to sit hidden behind the curtain or under the stage and used to write notes. Later on this, he wrote several books. Panditji owes a lot of credit to the students today for the linguistics available to them. Pandit Vishnu Digambar Pulaskar, another master of music, was also a contemporary of them. Both of them were known by the name of Dvivishnu. While Pandit Pulaskar's contribution was in exposing the functional side of music, Pandit Bhatkhande was a master figure in both the functional and the theoretical aspects. After observing the state of the music field, he decided to improve the situation both in practical and theory of classical music. First, he travelled to the southern part of India in 1904. They searched ancient books extensively. He discussed with many famous musicians. Similarly, he travelled to the northern part of the India and learned about northern Indian classical or Hindustani classical music. Some musicians refused to teach them anything until they did Ghanda Bandhan. Pandit Bhatkhande did not hesitate and went through the ceremony. The music sprout was in his heart from childhood. He also got an opportunity to listen to famous artists of Indian music art when he grew up, which greatly impressed him and aroused the musical interest. After this, he wished to get to know the music art more deeply. So, he came to Mumbai and got music education for a few days in singer Uchitjan Mandal and studied many books. He was involved in musical discussion with many music scholars from South India. At the same time, he also came to know about the 72 thoughts of Pandit Venkatamakhi for the first time. After this, Panditji travelled to northern and eastern India. In this journey, he got special knowledge of northern music system. He also learned many songs from various Kalavantas and met some music scholars and got some information about ancient and obsolete ragas. After this, he travelled to Vizianagaram, Hyderabad, Jagannath Puri, Nagpur and Calcutta and visited various cities of Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh in 1908. The discovery of handwritten music texts and publication of their names in their own texts in state country state, understate, institutional, monastery temple, and personal museums targeted, characteristically discussed and elaborated essays from many Hindu-Muslim singers in the country collection of a large number of lyrical verse in music script, determining the thought method of raga classification according to the ideal of Carnatical system. For all this work, he made extensive tours of all the regions of India. He listened to the music of big singers and after preparing his voice script, published a granthamala called Hindustani Sangeet Vidhiranik Pustak Malika, which has 6 parts. For classical knowledge, Vishnu Narayan Bhatkande wrote 4 parts of Hindustani music system, which was printed in Hindi under the name of Bhatkande Sangeet Shastra in Marathi language. In Sanskrit language too, he wrote books called Lakshya Sangeet and Abhinav Rag Manjari, and threw light on the characteristics of the ancient music and the frescoes spread in it. Vishnu Narayan Bhatkande, accepting his thought method as his pure thought Bilawal, categorized many ragas into 10 thoughts. To enable the future generation of the country to learn music, Panditji wrote a book called Swarmallika after deep study of Hindustani and Carnatic music system. That was considered as the basis for making the identification of ragas easily. Similarly, based on Carnatic style of music, he started singing Lakshan Geet. Panditji started many music schools. He wanted music education to have a streamlined pattern. Recognizing his talent, Baroda Naresh established a music school in his principality in 1916. After this, Gwalior Maharaja also gave his permission, which is today known as Madhav Sangeet Mahavidyalaya. In 1926, he opened a school in Lucknow, now named Bhatkande Sangeet Vidyalaya. The curriculum devised by Panditji is still recognized all over India. To connect the general public with music, he started All India Music Conference. Anyone could showcase their art in it. This gave many generations of musicians the opportunity to come on stage together. In 1933, he broke his leg and got paralyzed later on. For 3 years, he struggled with illness, and on the day of Ganesh Chaturthi, 19 September 1936, Panditji rested in peace. In his memory, the government of India issued a postage stamp on his birthday in 1961. And with this, today's lesson ends here. If you guys know any more information about Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhatkande, then feel free to share with us down in the comments. If you have liked today's video, then don't forget to drop a like to it and share it with your family and friends. If you have any queries, then feel free to contact us. You will get the contact details down in the description. To be notified when we upload the next amazing video, you should go and hit the subscribe button down below and push the bell icon. You can follow us over Facebook and Instagram also for more updates. Links are in the description. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video very soon.